yeah, Hellerup is the richest place in Denmark. There are more people here paying top tax than anywhere else in the country. Top tax kicks in after you've earned 557,000 kroner. Top tax is 50%. Coming up on the right, some of the old buildings that used to be part of the brewery. Also on the right, the old main gate with its lovely ornamental lamps on the top there on the right. And another old Tubor building, still proudly saying Tubor on the roof. Tubor and Carlsberg beers, they are now brewed in the same brewery, a great big brewery in Fredericia in southern Jutland. So, coming up ahead of us on the right-hand side is a newly thatched cottage. There it is, with its lovely bright yellow straw roof. It was thatched about 2 months ago. A thatched roof lasts for around about 50 years. As time goes by, the thatching turns light grey, then dark grey, then it starts having mould growing on the top of it, and that's when you've got to get the roof rethatched. An expensive process. Only about 8 people in the whole of Denmark know how to supervise the thatching of a house. Yet. So coming up on the right hand side are some little yellow brick houses. There they are on the right. They were designed by Jan Utzon. He also designed the Sydney Opera House. They can be in water which is deep enough to swim in. The word for village in Swedish is torp, T-O-R-P. As we approach our second destination today, which will be Lund in Sweden, you will see signs saying Stefanstorp, Stefan's village, as we approach Lund. And the Vikings, for a while, they ruled past parts of eastern England. And in eastern England, you can find places which are called Hogsthorpe, Hegsthorpe, Hexthorpe, or Scunthorpe. Thorpe being a derivative of torp. But we're now making our way along towards Helsingør, which is known as Elsinore in English. So coming up on the left hand side are some little ex-fishermen's cottages just there on the left hand side, now very desirable residences. A thatched roof is called a stråtag in Danish. The idea is that the water runs down the reeds, drip, drip, drips down off the roof. Problem is, when mould starts growing on the roof, it collects water, and then it's time to get your roof rethatched. These roofs here on the left, they've rethatched the tops. You can see the tops have got bright new yellow straw just there at the top on the left-hand side. A bit of a misty day. We can usually see Sweden across the water now, but not today. So we're now coming into the outskirts of Helsingør, which is known as Elsinore in English. So, coming up on the left-hand side, you've got the Elsinore Street Food Hall, which is where you can go. On the right, yeah, sorry, Maggie, you're right. On the right there, you've got the Elsinore Street Food Hall, where you can get food from various different places around the world. And the rest of the buildings, they are buildings which used to be part of the shipyard. The building right down, the last one on the right with the big glass windows, that's Culture Wharf. Down there in the basement, you can find toilets, washrooms, ASIOS down in the basement. There are also toilets, washrooms, ASIOS up at Kronborg Castle. So, back on the bus at 12:30, please. 12:30. For those of you who'd like to buy a ticket for the castle, I will walk you down to the ticket office. And for those of you who wish to take a little walk around Helsingør, just down there where that yellow house is on the corner, just take that little street and the third turning on the left, you'll find a little road with murals depicting the history of Helsingør. But whatever you do, come back to the bus, 12:30 please, 12:30. Have a great time in Helsingør.